All right. Hey, everybody. So I have a really cool opportunity to speak to an amazing author who wrote a really popular series. And no surprise, it deals with magic because that's apparently my thing lately. So I'm going to have her introduce herself and we'll go from there.
I'm V.E. Schwab. I also write as Victoria Schwab. I am the author of several series for children, teens, and adults, though I like to say there's like a lower age limit on all of them. There's no upper age limit. You don't age out. So as V.E. Schwab, I write Vicious and Vengeful, and of course the Shades of Magic series, which has the Steel Prince, which is the comic we're going to be talking about. I'm so excited to be here.
And I did kind of forewarn that it's been a while since I read the book, but what I do remember is that it's a very heavy magic system kind of world, and it's parallel worlds, mm-hmm. and there are colors. And I remember there was a red London, a black London, and I forgot the
white,
white London.
I have a very specific color scheme. I feel like I live in this color palette, so it's shocking. Apparently, when I was first working on them, like making notes, mm-hmm. I had like blue London ? And I would cross it out. It was like green London, crossed it out. So apparently I just have an aesthetic. Apparently though, Maxim has the exact same aesthetic as I do. So
it could have been like a Voltron.
Yes, sort of exactly. Exactly.
The other thing I remember about your magic system is that you could access these worlds, and it was kind of like hot potato a little bit. So it was like the closer you got, it was like
yes.
a heat thing. So can you just talk to us about
of
the
course.
Magic system?
Of course, here. So essentially it is about four Londons. I like to say that the magic system is like Harry Potter meets Avatar the Last Airbender with like a little touch of Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood thrown in, right?
So it's just
all the catnips. Essentially though, the worlds are set side by side like pages in a book. And so Black London, the kind of source of all power, the source of all magic, and then next to that is White London, and next to that is Red London, and next to that is Grey. And Grey London is our London. It's the furthest from the source of magic. It had the least amount of magic to start with. And it also has a great disadvantage in that the worlds have now been cut off from each other for about 300 years, and Grey London has forgotten about magic entirely. So how we got our current state. Red London has a very different relationship with magic. They basically worship magic like it's God. They have a huge amount of reverence for it. They believe in the balance of power. And then White London, because it was right next to Black London when Black London fell, when Black London essentially was so powerful that magic consumed the people and it doesn't exist really anymore. It's a deadscape. White London was so afraid of that happening to them that they went the opposite direction and they tried to enslave magic and they tried to force it and bind it to them. And what magic did in return, because it's a living thing, is it's been starving them out, which is why it's called White London. It's only these Londons are not officially called these things. Kel, the main character in first book, thinks of them via these color schemes. And the reason it's White London is because all of the color is leaching out of the world. And so it's like this pale scape, as though there's like a patina of snow on everything.
I remember reading this book and I was wondering, were you ever a Magic the Gathering player?
No. I know. In fact, though, there was a joke. The second book is called A Gathering of Shadows, and there was a joke in-house that they were calling it Magic the Gathering, and I was like, we are not calling this book Magic the Gathering. And then when Gathering of Shadows happened, I was like, God damn it, because you still got Gathering in there.
And then, we're actually really here to talk about the graphic novel, so I kind of wanted to do the introduction of the magic system. And so we have, like you mentioned, The Steel Prince. And I believe I understand it's not like a retelling series. It's kind of like a tangential story.
It's a prequel. Mm-hmm. So the king in the series is named Maxim Maresh. His son, Rai Maresh, is one of the four like main characters in the series. And Maxim's kind of a douche. He's like definitely not a great dad. He's a very good king. He's a very distinguished military figure, mm-hmm. but he's a shit parent. Sorry, I don't know if I'm allowed to cuss. Anyway, but in writing the Shades of Magic series, I got to book three, and I had to write this scene where an ambassador from another empire, the mm-hmm. Pharaohan ambassador, references the fact that he knew Maxim's reputation mm-hmm. before he was king, when he was, quote unquote, the Steel Prince. And the Steel Prince made his name at a place called the Blood Coast. It was the most lawless port in the Arnesian Empire. Oh, okay. And he lists three exploits that defined the Steel Princes. Wow. And the third one, the first one in this series, is the Steel Prince and the Pirate Queen. Oh. And so I decided when I had this opportunity to write a comic that was going to be in the same world, mm-hmm. to do a prequel comic about Maxim when he was Rai's age, as he is sent to the Blood Coast, basically exiled there by his father to mm-hmm. learn a lesson. Mm-hmm. And he is going to earn this reputation, come hell or high water, of the Steel Prince. He just doesn't know it yet.
Mm-hmm. I like that. I heard Pirate Queen.
Yeah. Oh, Pirate she's Queen. Such a total badass too. Mm. She's you meet her at the end of the first issue, and like, I have major like I just want to style myself. Like, she's a monster. She's a terrible person, but like, oh, her aesthetics are wonderful.
And actually, that kind of leads me to kind of the character designs.
Yeah.
Oh, this and it's you know it's very it's gorgeous, and I'm wondering, did you kind of have ideas with this? Was it like a collaboration? Can you talk about the character designs?
Yeah. So I'll show the character mm-hmm. design for Maxim. And aside from the color palette, I was really fortunate. My artist was able to show me a lot of different styles of armor and design, mm-hmm. and we worked really carefully. He would give me 3 or 4 iterations and be like, which style should we go with? And I'd be like, let's take this half cape, mm-hmm. and I want to make sure that we get the gold. But he did such a wonderful job, Andrea Olimpieri, of designing all of the garb in the series, mm-hmm. and I needed a way to give him something that just read prints, mm-hmm. even when he strips off the outer pieces, even when he's just in the whites, the underneath, it has to read royal.
It also looks very cosplayable.
Oh, I mean, I am not saying don't do it. That is such a goal for me, is I'm like, cosplay. People have started cosplaying as Kel and Lila from the series, and I love that, but I would be so happy if somebody would cosplay Maxim.
Now, is there kind of like an overall plan or like kind of like a tier in terms of the graphic novels in connection with the series? Like, what's kind of like your end goal? Or
so,
not end goal, but like overall plan.
I have no end goal. The end goal is just world domination. No, my primary goal is to get to tell the 3 exploits mm-hmm. of the Steel Prince. Once I do that, if I get to do all of that, mm-hmm. I would really love to tell at least a couple stories from White London and from Black London, because when we are introduced to Black London, it's already fallen. Mm-hmm. So we never actually get to see Oseron Vitari is mm-hmm. like one of the main villains of Shades of Magic, and he's the magic that came out of Black London. Okay. And I would really love to show Black London before it fell, to get to see this world that was the most powerful world. So, and obviously White London, the London that made the Dane twins, the London that made Holland, has mm-hmm. so many stories I didn't get to explore. Mm-hmm. So my hope is eventually one day, my grand design is to have comics which really explore the facets of this magic, of this London system.
And I'm always like a big fan of like multi-dimension in terms of stories, like novels and graphic novels. And just kind of like a little fun question, are you yourself a comic lover? And, you know, for those who either are going to read or have to read, like, what would you recommend for fans of Shades of Magic?
Oh, so I'm a really large comics fan. One of my favorites right now is Monstrous by Marjorie Liu.
Eisner.
It's so deserves it because it's gorgeous. Mm-hmm. I'm obviously a huge fan of Saga. Mm-hmm. I love The Wicked and the Divine mm-hmm. and Phonogram. I'm always looking for something new. You know, I came up through Marvel and DC. I'm a really big fan of Loki. So like Agent of Asgard and Young Avengers are really, really a couple of my favorites. But honestly, I'm not as well versed in comics as I'd like to be. I came up through anime. So that's a cool. lot of my references, a lot of my aesthetic choices are like because I grew up with Cowboy Bebop and Trigun and I love Psycho Pass right now. Like I have really weird and My Hero Academia, which is so off brand for me. I shouldn't even say it, but I love it so much. But yeah, so I came up through a lot of visual medium.
Cool. And another popular thing I've noticed that a lot of authors are doing are like playlists for their stories. Do you have a playlist for Shades of Magic?
You know, I do, but I use playlists in ways that aren't always great for like public consumption because mm-hmm. I pick like one song for a character and then I just play it over and over and over in my head. Or what's really interesting is for Shades of Magic, mm-hmm. I actually picked the playlist for a game, Bastion.
Oh.
Bastion's soundtrack is so perfect for Shades of Magic that I would just listen to that whole soundtrack on repeat while I was working.
Perfect.
Yeah.
And then what would be like your final message for those who are not familiar with Shades of Magic? Would you recommend them to read the novel first or just go ahead and jump into the graphic novel?
That's a great question. I think you should start with the novels because even though there's a spread at the beginning of Shades of Magic, Steel Prince, that kind of tells you how the worlds fell apart, I think you will appreciate the worlds of the comic more if you are coming from the book. It's not necessary. The design is that you can definitely start with the comics, and I hope that we do find people who start with the comics and go to the books. But if you have the luxury of choice, if you're trying to decide, I would at least read A Darker Shade of Magic, the first book, before going to the comic.
Perfect. Perfect. Well, thank you so much for taking the time. Congratulations on a book and a graphic novel, like two levels of awesome. And we all look forward to reading it.
Thank you so much.
Cool.